Yo, yo, what up, my beautiful Dowdies? How's everyone doing today? I'm your host, Fao, and let's talk about DOT. For the past few weeks, I have been making a lot of videos about DOT, talking about that DOT is not complete, and we really need units that complete this composition. All the other compositions are starting to get a lot of puzzle pieces, and DOT is still standing still from like a few months ago. Black Swan is the only real addition that we got for DOT, for the Kafka composition, you know? But I think I have good news. Now, this is of course not confirmed, this is just my speculation, but Kafka and Black Swan are being rerun together in that whole new big rerun fest, right? With the new patch with Fei Xiao and Ling Xia, we're getting not two, but four reruns. And this is a very big step for Honkai Star Rail, and the whole rerun system is very interesting to talk about of what the future of that is. But in this video, I really wanted to talk about the specific characters in the rerun, none other than Kafka Black Swan, because I find it very suspicious. Why, out of all times, all of a sudden are Kafka and Black Swan being rerun? Now, I suspect an upcoming DOT character for Kafka Black Swan. And here's why. First of all, it is almost inevitable, right? If Honkai Star Rail, from now to the end of time, will never ever make a DOT synergistic character ever again, that'd be weird, right? I do think that they implemented the DOT and all like the shield breaking from fire, electricity, wind, physical, whatever it is, it's a very big mechanic in the game. So it's almost inevitable that we don't get like some sort of premium comp at some point. But Kafka got released all the way in the beginning. And when she came out, DOT was already in a very weird position, right? They made her to be like a very special character that would make DOT great, and it could only become better from that moment on that Kafka got released. Now, she had a whole trouble and very disgusting past, right? Because she was always in an awkward position. Now, half a year ago, we got Black Swan, and Black Swan was the first eye-opener on like, whoa, okay, DOT is crazy, right? Kafka has a lot of potential. DOT roster as a whole, the DOT composition, this is a force to be reckoned with the more units we're going to get. Now, Kafka Black Swan became peanut butter jelly, and they, till to this day, are clearing content, and I'm also a DOT lover. I still use my Kafka Black Swan for the majority of my content, and I would say that's one of my better teams, and it's very comfortable, and they're still very strong. However, we're missing puzzle pieces. This composition could be like top three if we get the right units for this synergy. And now they're being rerun together. We all know how Hoyaverse plays. This is not a new thing in the game. Look at follow-up attack, guys. Fei Xiao, Robin, Topaz, and now Ling Xia that also works with follow-up attack. Or could work. This whole patch, if you want to start picking up follow-up attack, well, good luck. You have to do it in a few weeks' time, right? And they do this all the time, where they just put out characters back-to-back that are very synergistic and work very well together. I think it's very suspicious that Kafka and Black Swan are being rerun. First of all, their spot is awkward. Like, why are they all of a sudden between all the follow-up attack characters? So this means that already they're pairing them together, right? If you want to pick up DOT, same boat there. You have to pick up Kafka and Black Swan. If you pick one of the two and you don't pick up the other, you're missing out on like 80% value, right? You should pick up both of them, and you should have a guarantee for both of them if you really care about DOT. Now, let's say you do not have Kafka or Black Swan, and there would be a new character that comes out soon that is DOT synergistic. What are you gonna do then? Pick up that character, and then you have nothing else. So they are sneaky here, I think. They are foreshadowing. They are making you make a decision now. They're like, okay, are you gonna pick up the quote-unquote bad composition for DOT, you know? Are you gonna settle for something less? Or are you gonna invest in the full OP, well-structured follow-up attack right now? They have put out characters many times that have been very synergistic later on. Let's look at RERUN. RERUN came out and she had a pretty good setup. Just like when Black Swan came out, she had a really good setup, but it was not ideal and it was not max possibility or capabilities, just max value, right? The max possible damage you can do. RERUN also had to go in that waiting game where now, just recently, this patch, we got her signature support. I just suspect that the way they're putting out the characters, the way they're structured, the way the reruns are functioning right now, they are building up a hype and they're building up value. Sometimes, however, it's really sneaky in a way, but it just makes psychological gain by pulling for these characters, right? Kafka and Black Swan are being put out together next patch. What that means is you have to be patient and you have to stay strong. if you're a GOT lover, you should be excited because right now you're like, okay, it is very possible that maybe after Rapa or whatever, there's going to be a new synergistic support made for DOT or the third slot character or sustainer, whatever it is. If you did not pick up Kafka Black Swan and the character that comes out that is DOT synergistic and the character is really cool and you love this character, now makes you need Kafka and Black Swan. So this gives you another character added to your roster that needs proper build and other characters. So they're like chain firing characters at us, they're literally shooting at us, right, to try to break our free to play. What I'm trying to say with this is that they're literally putting characters in our faces and they're putting options in our faces. And the people that can't contain themselves for trying to collect all these characters or can't contain themselves by choosing specific paths, like just, or you're a follow-up main and you may be a break main or your DOT main, a hyper carry main, those people will break. Those people cannot play the game properly and they will have to put out their wallet. Because if you do not have Kafka Black Swan, the new character comes out, you now need the next rerun for Kafka Black Swan, or you need to skip that character, or you just have a worthless character on your account that you pulled with real money because you wanted that one so much after you spent all your resources on the follow-up attack. So now you spent money for no reason, and you're probably going to spend money again later on when Kafka and Black Swan get rerun again. So it's just a roller coaster of trying to break your mental and trying to get you everything possible, right? And it's been a very long time since we have actually seen a DOT synergistic character. So that Kafka and Black Swan are being put out right now is just weird. Because some characters are literally out there to make you collect the other puzzle pieces. RERUN is a very good example for that. When RERUN came out, everyone was in love. Everyone loved her design, everyone loved her playstyle, everyone loved her damage. She did not have good puzzle pieces around her. You had puzzle pieces that worked with her, but now JQ came out, and you're almost forced to pull for him, right? If you're an RERUN main. You're almost forced to pick up this puzzle piece if you do want the most premium setup. And this character came out way later. Black Swan is also kind of one of those puzzle pieces. Black Swan was almost, if you had Kafka, you were almost forced to pull for Black Swan, or else why did you pull Kafka in the first place, right? Now, this is what these certain characters will do. So I suspect now a character to show up soon that is DOT synergistic, and because you skip both Kafka Black Swan now, you now have a puzzle piece, and now later on, you're forced to pull Kafka Black Swan to make that specific character really shine and work. This was the same thing when Robin and Aventurine came out with Topaz. Two times in a row, Topaz and Robin are just there synergistic. Dr. Ratio came out, we got him for free. Then all of a sudden, we got Topaz and Robin. Topaz is the rerun, and then Robin is a new character. And then Aventurine was also there before. So almost like, if you really loved follow-up attack, all of a sudden they bombed you with so many characters that synergistic with it, right? And you're almost like, oh, I have to go for these, you know? They just make you sway in and they make you pull. And you're literally trying to break your patience and your mental and your plan in this game. Now, there's many characters that do that. Dill as well. Dill, when Dill got released, cool and all, but when Sparkle came out, we're almost forced to pull for that character to really make Dill work. Now, this is what I'm trying to say with this video. I think that Kafka and Black Swan are extremely suspicious why they're so randomly put out both together in the next patch. I suspect a DOT character to show up. Now, people that have Kafka and Black Swan, we are chilling, right? We are already like smooth sailing. We know what's up because we love this comp and we're just being patient. Same boat for me. I have almost 400 tickets saved up because I know, don't fall for the Fei Xiao, don't fall for the RERUN, don't fall for the Firefly. I'm going to be so sad if I got baited in getting all those characters. Now, those characters need other support, so I have to summon on those. And then when the day actually is arriving that the DOT support or the third slot is there, the new character, I'm empty-handed and I have to grab my wallet to get the actual character that I want. This is what the whole structure of gacha gaming is. And Honkai Star Rail is extremely good at this. I think Honkai Star Rail is the best gacha game on the market right now that has such a well-built structure. They have this so under control. They have everything sorted out. They have the story ahead. Like, you guys don't want to know how much they control all of the upcoming characters, all about the story, all about, like, they have everything under control and they have everything planned ahead. So this is why I'm warning you guys. So this is a video that is, of course, talking about the relationship with you guys with Starrio and the gacha system. I'm trying to make it as positive and most accessible for you guys, because most of us are free-to-play players, me too. You have to stick to your plan. You have to not get baited. They're going to try to do that with cool character designs, cool play styles, you know. Stick to the plan. If you love DOT, skip Fei Xiao and the whole shenanigan with follow-up attack. They're not worth your time. Pick both Kafka Black Swan and then wait for the third slot. If you already have Kafka Black Swan, don't fall in the trap where you all of a sudden just waste all your tickets, try to get cool new characters. Wait. I can promise you they're probably going to now put up a DOT character soon to repeat the cycle again. Because now you pull for all of the follow-up attack characters, you skip Kafka Black Swan, cool new DOT character comes out, and then you have to pull Kafka Black Swan anyway, right? So they're trying to take all your resources, guys. This is very suspicious, and they're going to do this with multiple characters. Lingxia, we're probably going to get a very good break character soon. Or this is going to be a very good puzzle piece for your Firefly Boot Heel slash Run May, right? They are trying to take all the possibility, every patch, to make a very good option for you, right? To give you a very valuable unit that you could use or could, like, play around with. Be careful. Be patient. Stick to your plan. DOT lovers out there, this is a patch that is going to be rough, right? If you have enough tickets, be wise, you know. I would always, for you guys, I would really recommend just saving 180 tickets just to get that guaranteed new DOT character. Now, you could also go further ahead that you save two characters guaranteed, or a character plus a light cone, whatever you want to do, right? Be wise. Don't go to zero. And then when that time comes, all of a sudden there's a new character that you actually care about. You're going to be empty-handed, and that's going to be a very dark day for you. Let me know in the comments down below what you guys think about the whole rerun system and the placements of these characters and what Kafka and Black Swan's value is going to be, right? If you think there is a character coming up, if you shouldn't stress at all, Kafka Black Swan might not get a DOT character in for a very long time. How the whole system is working, you know, what you guys think about their implementation of characters and their planning ahead, you know, if it's not that deep, if you also think like, yeah, there's something sussy here, you know, they are always foreshadowing with a bunch of these things, because I know they have been doing this for many times. They love foreshadowing. They love sneak peeking, and they just love to get your money. So be wise. And I would love to hear your guys' takes and stories. And just your plans as well, right? What you're going to do and how you're going to get through this very hard patch with a bunch of new characters. We can all help each other out here in the comments down below. This video is not trying to bait you in or make you pull for a certain character or make you skip a certain character. This video is purely made to keep your eyes open and fresh, to keep your mind fresh, you know? Don't get baited by these gacha systems. Stick to your plan, stick what you like. Fun to play is the most important thing in these type of games. If you're not having fun with your most favorite synergy or composition or characters, then you're just, in the long run, not going to have fun, you know? Stick to your plan and play for fun. Very important. Hey, if this video helped you out, make sure to like and subscribe. Really helps out the channel. Means the world to me if you could do that. Make sure to join the Discord. We're trying to grow the community even further. And if you want to support the channel even further, then become a member. I love you all, and I'll see everyone in the next video. Take care. Peace.